Hi, I'm Marine Corps veteran Paul Corbett, and if you are wondering what a benefits package looks like for a veteran who is receiving 50% service-connected disability through the VA, then look no further. In this video, I will be covering the top 10 benefits offered to veterans with 50% service connection, and if you want additional information about any of the benefits I'll be discussing, please refer to the video description below. So let's get started with number 10. Which is monetary compensation. Based on rates for 2021, a veteran with 50% disability can expect at the very least to receive $905 a month tax-free. And a little later in this video, I'll explain how that number could grow by hundreds of additional dollars. Number 9 is free health care and medications. Making the leap from 40% to 50% quite literally changes the entire ballgame with regard to healthcare costs. When a veteran hits 50%, they are now covered for just about everything VA healthcare offers with no out-of-pocket expenses. With VA, you have access to everything from a flu shot to complex surgeries, but they can also assist with education, housing, nursing home care, and tons of other programs you won't find at your local hospital. So be sure to enroll if you haven't done so already. Number 8 is travel allowance. That's right. The VA will cover travel costs such as mileage, cab and train fare, and other expenses associated with you getting to a VA facility for a medical appointment. For details, be sure to reference the video description below. Number 7 is waivers of funding fees for VA home loans. Normally, there is a 1 to 4% funding fee associated with using a VA home loan to purchase a home. However, with being 50% disabled, that fee is completely waived. And for additional details, be sure to check out the link below. Number 6 is hiring preference. As a veteran who receives 50% disability, you qualify for a 10-point preference. This can be extremely beneficial if you are seeking employment in the government sector. Moreover, you also qualify to be direct hired, meaning that a government agency has the ability to hire you on the spot, so long as you meet the qualifications for that position. It doesn't mean they have to hire you, but it is an option that exists, and I would highly encourage you to speak with the HR department of that agency for which you are seeking employment for additional details. Number 5 is veteran readiness and employment, or what used to be called vocational rehabilitation and employment. If you are a veteran who is looking to gain permanent employment or is in a job that aggravates one of your current VA disabilities, then I highly recommend looking into VR&E. It is an awesome program that I have used myself and, in my opinion, is like the GI Bill on steroids. Now, not every veteran is going to qualify to use VR&E, but it is well worth investigating. To learn more, check out the link below or call your regional VBA office and schedule an appointment with a VR&E counselor. Number 4 is additional compensation for eligible dependents. VA recognizes the fact that many veterans are on fixed incomes and that every dollar counts. As such, VA provides additional money to your monthly disability compensation for your spouse, qualified children, and in some cases, even your parents. So depending on the number and types of dependents you have, your monthly compensation could jump to as much as $1,200 or more per month. To learn more about this, be sure to check out the web link in the video description below. Number 3 is concurrent receipt of military retired pay. Many people don't know this, but until you hit 50% disability, veterans may not receive their full military retirement and VA disability. There is a potential offset as to maximize the amount a veteran makes every month. However, with being 50% service connected, you now begin receiving your full military retirement and full VA disability each and every month. Number 2 is burial and plot allowance. There are a bunch of different scenarios that govern this benefit, such as whether a veteran's death was due to a VA disability, if they passed away at home or in a VA facility, and the list goes on. Nevertheless, VA can potentially help with the cost of procuring a plot and also with covering as much as $2,000 in burial expenses. To learn more about this benefit or locate the paperwork that you need to apply, please refer to the video description below. The last and final benefit that is afforded to veterans with 50% disability is access to certain DOD facilities, such as commissaries, exchanges, and other retail and recreational programs or facilities, which is a pretty sweet benefit, especially if you live close to a military base. You're able to take advantage of this benefit online or in person. And for additional information about this benefit or any of the others I've discussed, be sure to visit the video description below for web links and instructions.
You have questions? We have answers. The SITREP is your trusted source for veterans benefits information with expert analysis and interviews with leaders from the field. To find past shows, podcasts, and other content, search #TheSITREP on YouTube.